I want to make a circuit that can solder itself by just connecting two wires to it, and I want to use the same circuit to solder other PCBs like it in midair, the reprep way. I really like to compare reflow soldering with pizza making. The PCB is like the dough, the solder paste is the sauce, and the toppings are the electronics. The oven's heat is what bonds these individual items together. So using the same analogy, making a self-soldering circuit is going to be like putting the oven in the dough and make it edible. PCBs are made from multiple layers of copper stacked together. One of those layers is usually a solid ground plane, and if we chop this up into a one long trick, it can also be used as a small resistor that heats up and melts the solder. The bummer is that this layer will only be used one time, so it will kind of be stuck in the FR4 forever. So what I'm thinking is that after the PCB gets soldered, I short it to ground, so this can also be used as a ground plane. And I think that makes sense, right? This is the circuit that I chose to do the first test with. But as you can see, there are vias and holes that makes laying out the thermal track a little bit harder. But luckily Altium Designer has this interactive length tuning feature that automatically avoids the obstacles for you. And as you can see, the track is passing underneath all the components. I connected the track to these two pads over here, which are surrounded with mouse bite vias, so that I can remove this part when it's soldered. The track will also get directly soldered to ground once this 0-ohm resistor gets soldered. I will explain how this circuit works later on in the video, and if you'd like to get a free trial of Altium Designer, check out the link in the description. There you can also get 25% off any purchased license.
So somewhere in there should be a secret heater.
The goal was to keep the resistance as small as possible so that it wouldn't need a high voltage to reflow. In fact, it reached 165 degrees at around 9 volts. This is the maximum temperature that the PCB has to reach in order to melt the slow temperature solder paste. This may seem a little bit high considering that the temperature has to come from in between the layers, but the PCB has a TG value of 170 degrees Celsius, which is a little bit more pricey. Besides this, the board only has to reflow one time for less than 5 minutes, so it will kind of be like putting it on a hot plate. As you can see, every single component that's going to be soldered is surface mount, so that I avoid hand soldering. Everything looks okay, time to power it on. I'm going to slowly increase the voltage. Yep, it's happening. We have officially cooked our first PCB. There are some soldering blobs, but nothing that can be fixed. Damn, that looks so good. Okay, so the board has cooled off and there's zero sign of delamination. Now here's when the fun really starts. So far I have been manually increasing the board's temperature by hand, which did an okay job, but a computer can definitely do it better by reflowing the solder paste with its exact temperature profile. And that's what this circuit is going to do. As you can see, the PCB does not only has a thermal input, but also a thermal output. These pins are connected to a MOSFET transistor, which can be turned on and off using this Atmega32U4 microcontroller, and the software will read the temperature from the thermocouple sensor, and when the user presses the start button, it will implement a PID controller to match the reflow temperature profile. So we can kind of say that this board is like a mother that can reflow other daughter PCBs. The only problem is that our motherboard has flaws. This was my first time using the Atmega32 on a custom PCB, and for some reason I thought that its serial to USB module would come with a pre-flashed bootloader. So I had to flash the Arduino bootloader by soldering some wires to the chip. Once the bootloader was uploaded, I removed these wires and uploaded my software sketch directly through the USB, which led to the discovery of more issues. The reading from the temperature sensor was glitching. This was fixed by replacing the 22 microfarad ceramic capacitor with a larger electrolytic one. I also had to rewire the LEDs and one of the switch because they were sharing the same pins as the ISP programming pins. So to make this work, the board ended up with a couple of modifications, but the cool thing is that we can still use it to reflow a new daughter PCB that doesn't contain its mother flaws. Let's all say a big thank you to PCBWay for manufacturing this lovely new board again. I kind of made the mistake not taking the inch finish for this one, so I guess we can take this opportunity to test the hazel surface finish. Okay, so all the components are assembled and ready to be soldered. This is mother to daughter test. Testing in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Okay, so the temperature is slowly climbing. Now it has reached 90 degrees and is going up with a slower gradient. Now it's climbing much faster to reach 165 degrees Celsius.
So it should happen in a second now. The board is cooling off. Yep, it's done. I think we have a new daughter PCB. I flashed the bootloader from the new programming pins and then I uploaded the same firmware. This is now officially the new mother. I assembled the other daughter board to test the new mother and it soldered it pretty well. Now the coolest thing about this is that all these mothers can solder other new circuits, which means that we're kind of building circuits that can solder other circuits, which can solder other circuits. And the loop continues, which means that we're kind of doing like soldering re-prep, which is like so freaking cool. I can definitely see this technology gets combined with like a pick and place. Obviously this design is not the only one that can use the thermal grounded heater. It can actually be combined with any PCB. I made this small daughter test board that has an LED ring light and all the serviceable LEDs managed to get soldered. The only thing that didn't was the 0 ohm resistor, but this was definitely my fault because I didn't cover the terminal track underneath this component. Anyway, if you'd like to get into self-reflowing PCBs, this project is open source and all its files are available on GitHub. If you're making a custom PCB, always remember to use low temperature solder paste and not to overpower the track because it can get delaminated or catch on fire.
That was way too many smoke.
If you'd like to learn more about thermal circuits, check out some of my other videos. But before going there, just remember to like this video, subscribe, and consider becoming a Patreon.
There it is, our thermal track.